Hey everyone, C-Drama Invasion here, and I'm back with a new video. If you're new to my channel, I make a bunch of videos on facts and profiles of popular actors and actresses from Korea and China. So these are a little bit different, and this is where I just cover what the cast of very famous dramas are up to these days and what are their upcoming dramas. So if you're into this type of content, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up to let me know if I should continue on or switch it up. And make sure to leave comments down below for the next drama you want me to cover. And while you're at it, make sure you check out my previous video, which I'll leave a link down below in the description box so you can check that out after. And also, please, please, please subscribe. It would really, really help me out. Thank you so much. Let's just jump into it. Today's topic is, as seen in the title, what is the Goblin cast up to? Let's kick things off with Lee Dong-wook, which is one of my favorite Korean actors of all time. Lee Dong-wook was born on November 6 in 1981. He landed his first ever debut main role lead in 2002's Loving You, but the dramas he was most known for from his career is My Girl, which is a 2005 classic rom-com, and also Goblin as you know it, and recently 2019's Stranger from Hell. As for upcoming works, his first work is a 2020 movie called Single in Seoul, and this is a drama and melodrama romance movie. So this movie will be played by Im Soo-jung, who is super well known for a lot of her roles previously. She's been in Search WW, and she's just a veteran in this career. Anyways, the plot follows two people who are super different about their outlooks in life, and they meet through writing an essay about their views on relationships and being single. There hasn't been too much news on this yet, but I'm excited to see it. And aside from this, Lee Dong-wook is also working on a very popular upcoming drama. This is one of my highly anticipated dramas, and this is called Tale of Nine Tailed, and it is supposed to air around September, so fall of 2020. This drama stars Lee Dong-wook, Jo Bo-ah, and Kim Bum. This drama follows a mystical nine-tailed fox named Lee Rang, which will be played by Kim Bum's character, the second male lead, who is the stepbrother of Lee Dong-wook's character. And these Gumihos just moved to the city, so they're nine-tailed fox. Meanwhile, the main female lead is in charge of a television show that features urban myths and legends, and she invites one of them to join her show, but realizes that they're not as nice as they seem, and there's a darker secret to them. And I think this sounds so good, and I cannot wait for this drama to air. Next up, let's talk about his co-star Yoo In-ah, who played Sunny, which was his female love interest in Goblin. So after Goblin, she did a couple of guest roles on dramas, but most notably was her 2019 drama Touch Your Heart, which also featured Lee Dong-wook as the male lead. So these two are quite close in real life and they're quite good friends. She was born on June 5th in 1982. She is born in the same year as Lee Dong-wook, and they're both the same age. Anyways, after her popularity surged after filming Goblin, she has been consistently on many variety shows, so you can catch her on variety shows such as Funding Together, and she will be the main host for 2020's variety show called Love of 7.7 Billion. Similar to Lee Dong-wook, she is also going to star in a movie this year, and this should come out in the winter of 2021 or 2020. Anyways, this is called New Year's Eve, and it is a story about four couples who overcome different fears and problems as they face the beginning of a new year. This movie will star Yoo In-ah and Kim Kang-woo, and the genre of this movie is supposed to be comedy, romance, and drama. Her upcoming drama is called The Spy Who Loved Me, and this should also premiere sometime this fall around October to November. So The Spy Who Loved Me stars Yoo In-na, Eric Moon, and Im Joo-hwan as the three main roles. So this is a suspense rom-com about a woman who gets caught in the world of espionage. She basically got married two times, and her ex-husband is actually a cop, and her husband right now is actually a spy. So this sounds so interesting, and I think it would make a lot of comedic moments as well as a lot of intense cat and mouse moments. Now let's talk about Yook Seung-jae, who played a great side character in Goblin. Anyways, Yook Seung-jae is a Korean singer, songwriter, and an idol as well as an actor. So he is known to be in the group B2B, and he is signed to Cube Entertainment. His birthday is May 2nd, 1995. After being a part of Goblin, he actually took a 4-year break and just returned recently with the 2020 drama Mystic Pop-Up Bar. Most of his attention and time was dedicated to his group's comeback and writing music, as well as appearing on variety shows, such as being a regular member of Master in the House. Seung-jae was also on Pretty 95's, a 2019 variety show, as the main host, and he appeared here and there on variety shows such as Busted Season 2 and Happy Together Season 4. And for now, he has no upcoming works, and that is because his entertainment announced that in May of 2020, he officially joined the military and said that he will be discharged in November of 2021. Next, let's talk about Kim So-hyun. Even though she played a minor role in Goblin as the younger sister of Kim Shin, which is the main male lead, since she is a pretty prominent face, I decided to update on her upcoming dramas as well. So she was born on June 4th in 1999. If you want me to do a full-length 10-minute video on her life and facts, then let me know in the comments below and I'll definitely do it. She started her drama acting career as a young child actress in 2006 and then rose to fame slowly and steadily. But after 2016's Goblin, she went on to do a couple of big dramas such as Radio Romance, The Tale of Nokdu, and Love Alarm. So this year she will be starring in Love Alarm Season 2. This drama will air on Netflix on August 22nd, so quite soon for people who are a fan of the first season. I haven't seen it myself, but let me know down in the comments below what your thoughts are and whether or not you recommend it. This is a friendship comedy romance school drama starring Kim So-hyun as the female lead and Song Kang as the male lead. So Love Alarm is about people who know their true heart in society and where they use an app to find out who likes them. It is based off of a popular webtoon. I believe there's a love triangle involved in this one with Jung Ga-ram's character, who plays Lee Hae-young. Now let's talk about the main pairing in Goblin. So first let's talk about the female lead, played by Kim Go-eun. And Kim Go-eun was born on July 2nd in 1991. So she was recently in The King Eternal Monarch, which was super popular. It starred Lee Min-ho and had very similar supernatural themes to Goblin. Kim Go-eun has one upcoming 2020 or 2021 movie, which is called Hero. And this is a musical historical action movie that stars Jung Sung-hwa as the main male lead, and this is based off of a true story about Korean independence movement. In this movie, Kim Go-eun's character will go undercover as a geisha to give intel to the Korean independence movement about their Japanese rivals, and they want to take back the country of Korea. Lastly is a 2021 rumor that has been circling around a remake of the popular Netflix series called Money Heist, which I just binged, so I'm so excited for this if it works out well. And this is an action thriller, mystery, crime drama. So far, these are just rumors, so we're not sure who will end up playing who or if they're even going to be a part of the drama yet. But if there's news, I'll definitely update you later on. So make sure to stay subscribed and hit that notification bell. Last but definitely not least, we have actor Gong Yoo, who is born on July 10th in 1979. He is a well-known star and he was very popular in the early 2000s, such as in Biscuit Teacher and Star Candy, and also 2007's Coffee Prince. But Goblin was the drama that launched him into international success. So he took a 4-year break to focus on his mental health after Goblin, and stated in many interviews that there was just so much pressure to find a drama to act in and to follow up after the success of Goblin. He didn't want to let people down, but this year he will be making his long-awaited comeback. This drama will be a completely different genre, and it is called The Silent Sea, which is an 8-episode Netflix drama. So this drama should air sometime in December or January of 2020 or 2021, depending on when it airs. But The Silent Sea will star Gong Yoo and Bae Doona, as well as Lee Joon. The Silent Sea is a mystery, sci-fi thriller, horror drama that follows a group of elite scientists who set off to the moon to retrieve some unknown samples from an abandoned research facility. This sounds so good already, and there are some rumors that there will be dystopian themes to this, and it sounds so good. Gong Yoo has been phenomenal in these type of genres before, such as Train to Busan, so I'm very excited for this drama. Anyways, that is it for today's video. If you like this type of content, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up and check out the links in the description box below for a bunch of playlists of my previous videos. Thank you all for your support, and make sure to subscribe if you want to see more content coming. Anyways, I'll see you next time. Stay safe, stay happy. Bye.